Financial expert Rob Black and watching Apple stock and watching the watch.
It's coming, isn't it?
It is, but it's not going to be until somewhere between March and June.
Okay.
We wanted it early 2015. We heard rumors of February 14th, something we could fall in love with. But Angela Earhart's head of retail at Apple, formerly CEO of Burberry, where you can buy a $4,000 scarf, you can now buy up to a $20,000 iWatch starting sometime in the spring. So she confirmed it's coming. She's kind of delayed it a little bit. One thing that we also learned that starting to leak is that they're going to let you walk out of the store with it on your arm. They're not going to send you home with a box per se. So it's that experience that they want you to use and feel. So looks like we're going to have to wait to March or June of 2015. A little on the vague side, but she said spring, and she sent an internal video to employees on that. And she also said, hey, we got Christmas coming, and we got Chinese New Year coming. This is going to be a good time for us in retail.
Yeah, and so do you like the stock still? 105, 110, it's pretty high. I mean, do you like the stock at that price?
I don't think it has as much growth as it used to.
Okay.
And I think its income is a little low. I own shares. I think it can go higher. I think they're going to issue some bonds in euros. And they're a good company, but the best days, I'm not going to say, are behind it, but it's going to be a little bit slower going forward.
Okay, so like a Microsoft going forward.
It's got a good value.
Yes, it has a lot of cash, too, a lot of cash. All right, Virgin America going for an IPO here. This will be exciting. Very company, San Francisco.
Yeah, I love the product. They've been slowly expanding. They do fewer flights per day to short routes. I'm going to be taking them in the spring back to Washington, D.C. to see my mother. It's my first brand of choice, or my Mine first too. Choice. They've got a wonderful system. They've got that mood lighting. They've got, you can order, you know, high-end vodka, and they bring it to you. They don't do the cart service. A lot of things that were wrong with airlines, they're doing right. So they're going to come public. Last year, they made $41 million, up from $33 million. That's pretty good. Revenue is pretty anemic, up 4.7%. But again, well, they'll use that cash to maybe expand into some more markets that you and I are interested in. And you and I, it's our first brand of choice.
Yeah, we love the Virgin America.
Yep.
All right, let's talk about Taylor Swift and Spotify. A lot of people love their Spotify, but Taylor Swift not that interested in it, is she?
I love my Swiftie. I'm a Swiftie, as we all remember. Yes, it's terribly embarrassing to say, but fan of Taylor Swift, she's pulled all of her music from Spotify, rightfully so. Her new album, 1989, she wants to sell iTunes albums and iTunes singles. They get paid about a penny per play on Spotify, way beneath what they would be making elsewhere. And this was, you know, an op-ed piece that she wrote last year on, you know, piracy. She says, piracy, file sharing, streaming have shrunk numbers of paid album sales drastically. She's got 40 million users on Spotify that love her. With that said, like, the future of music, it's brutal because there's no barriers to entry of Pandora's and Spotify's. They can change radically when a big artist like Taylor Swift says, pulling my music, going to go back to Apple iTunes with it. So interesting to watch the evolution of music and where we're going.
And the haters going to hate, Rob. Let's got a question here from Isaac, and Isaac sends an email. It is now a good time to invest with markets at highs. You know, from mid-September to mid-October, we saw the Dow lose over 1,000 points, and then we got it all back in the last couple weeks.
Yeah, and we're up, you know, almost 9% for the year. On Friday, we hit all-time highs on the S&P 500. Like, whoa, weren't we just talking correction at the beginning of October? Long story short, this is the best 3-month period, 6-month period, 12-month period to invest, midterm elections. I know that sounds weird, but, you know, Stock Traders Almanac, November has been a good month for the S&P 500, up 2.7% on average. But in historic years of midterm elections, 18 out of 18 times we've been up 1 year after the elections, 18 out of 18 times we've been up 6 months after the election, and 17 out of 18 times we've been up in a 3-month duration. So history says invest. I say, you know, be cautious, but again, stay in the market for the long-term patient investor.
All right, thank you, Rob. If you have a question for Rob, put it on his Facebook fan page. We'll answer it right here on Chrome 4. This morning, firefighters responding to a garage fire. They set a home in Concord, and Crown Force Will Trent live on the scene right now with more on what happened. Will?
Mark, they're still here. It's been nearly 2 hours since the fire broke out. It destroyed the home.